Now, first off, Davido threatens to quit music following the alleged brawl between Nigerian superstars Burna Boy and Davido in a nightclub in Ghana. The DMW boss has come out to open up about his current state of mind. He tweeted, "I go leave this music for una." Davido further agreed with a Twitter user who wrote that he's being envied because he's from a rich home. The Twitter user at K1 Says wrote, "I agree now. The envy is too much on this lad. He didn't even ask to be born rich. All he wants to do is make good music and leave a legacy." In agreement, Davido shared a screenshot of that tweet on his Instagram page with the caption, "Everyone knows this is the truth. 10 years I've been fighting this blip, but I swear nobody go see me finish again. I will continue to deliver you guys hits. Too late." He also shared another caption with a reposted screenshot from a blog writing, "It's bleeping true. Too late. Make una can't kill me now. We dey game. Hits go continue come out." Davido has since been posting various cryptic messages on his Instagram page. Well, the details of what really happened at the Ghana nightclub are still very sketchy, as the other parties involved have remained mute about the alleged brawl.
Yes, so but certainly not still very Davido. Sketchy. Davido has not been mute on social media,
no,
my
he
dear
has
lady.
Not.
Davido has been posting every hour on his Instagram self. Like, he puts one, maybe puts a picture of him and his guys, something too late. Then he puts another one of the tweet screenshot. Then he puts another one. And I'm just like, David. Then put one, a Bible verse. And in the so-so day, David was so-so child, Bible verse. And I was like, okay, what's going on? So, obviously, or definitely, from what I am seeing, from the way that, because you know Davido, you first get it from him. He's the one that would react and everything. So from what he's putting out, I'm sensing that definitely something went down in Ghana. Definitely, it is possible that this fight really happened, even though we haven't seen a proper video yet. Ghanaians were not happy with you, by the way. If that had happened in Nigeria, we know they waste time. Phone would have been out, and with a proper video, people are showing us whiskey, sipping drink. Anyway, that's for another day. So, what to come? What's it? What is it? Anyway, I think something definitely went down, and I just feel like at this so. K Solo, producer K Solo, and is very active on social media. He commented on one of the posts Davido put out, and he was like, "David, I beg, do and drop this jam that you want to drop." And also, somebody please take his phone. So I feel like a song is coming, probably titled Tule,
because probably,
they're trying
because
to get this, they're trying to get it to trend. But also, I think someone really needs to take David's phone. Asa, you and your guys, please take David's phone off him. Honestly, I know we've been very accommodating of how Davido is. He's very, you know, open. He's very outspoken. But sometimes, just chill. You're the only one talking about it. Like, no one, you're the only one putting out stuff. No one else is doing that. It's like, but you're not even telling us anything. It's, you're just saying, and it's like, it feels like you're in a war with yourself. 10 years, 10 bloody years, 10...
Okay. David. Okay, so I think I agreed with you to a particular extent. Until you said they should take his phone from him. Now, I would have said this before. If this was Burna Boy, I'd be like, take his phone away. Because Burna Boy is going to come and call out some people, right? However, I genuinely feel like Davido has had this heat on for the past 10 years since Madam Duru that he brought out, where people said, oh, this rich kid's son. And he has been facing this constant backlash. Oh, it's because he's rich. I say it too. Oh, his voice is this. But one thing you can't deny is that he has given us hits back to back. One thing you can't deny is that he's a fantastic artist. One thing you can't deny is that he has broken international boundaries and barriers. So give David his accolades. Why do I keep calling him David? Give David his accolades.
Who's dragging the accolades with him?
He really feels like he has to always explain himself.
Why do you always have to explain? You don't.
So the thing is that I think these are bottled up issues.
Yes.
The fact that David's father is very rich and from the outset, people did not believe in him. They've always, made reference to, his father is rich and all that. Would you please just cut him some slack? This is the same thing DJ Copy faces every time.
Yeah.
So whether he's now bringing emotions out because of this that happened, I mean, I can't blame him to a large extent because it's human at the end of the day. Okay, you'd say, oh, he's the one always talking about it. Oh, Wizkid's attitude should be studied in school.
Love it.
I mean, I'm just saying here that temperaments are different, people mm-hmm. are different, mm-hmm. and this is definitely bottled up.
Yeah.
He's talking about everything is been through. Yeah. So, I mean...
And then one good thing that Davido does is that he actually replies the good comments too. I mean, you see random people on Twitter say, Davido, bloggers say, Davido say he won't make heaven. And he's like, my brother, go make him, yourself, you'll be there. He's interacting with his fans. I like the fact that he does that. I like the fact that he actually comments on every caption. He's a celebrity that feels like a friend. If you follow him, friend is a bit too.
So
much.
I know that I had this discussion with OJ, and OJ was like, what are you talking about? How would you say that Davido should be interacting with people and be doing
he
this?
Always does so.
But people are different. We love Davido like that. Okay. Let him interact. Let him be in that
combo. That's what I'm saying.
To an extent, I agree. I like that Davido he's very interactive on social media. Mm-hmm. I like that. However, I think even if you react now and do this, people are still going to talk.
Definitely.
People have, it's a rich kid syndrome. It happens a lot in Nigeria, even in the world, where people feel like, oh, you're a rich kid, so your efforts are, should be undermined because you got them from your father or mother's wealth. So that's always going to be a thing. I mean, I feel like Copy has understood that people will keep talking. Let me just give them something. At least from what we see from social media. So I don't know what she deals with personally, but I mean, from the way that
she
we see her
exactly
portrays it on social media, it feels like she understands that these people will forever talk. If I want to reply them, I will, but let me keep putting my music. We doubted her, said she's a crappy DJ, said so many things. Up until this point, this girl put out an album and people actually love it. She has managed to prove herself, and Davido has done that. Quiet, block out the noise and focus on just giving us these hits. Forget about, they will still talk. There's nothing you do. People will still say, oh, is your daddy's money? So you might as well just focus on the work and focus on, don't distract
give it
from
some
it. That's
time.
All I'm saying.
Give
That's all
time.
I'm saying.
It'll come around.
We hope so.
Our thoughts are with you, David.
Yeah.
Feel better, bro. Feel
this
better.
This one that we're just calling David, Oliver.
Yeah,
David.
I think calls him David.
Foladele, keep your sorry to yourself.
Sorry,
David.
Really?
Feel better, David.
Did you just have a communication with David the other day?
David,
this one that you're doing, David.
David. Even Mr. Sai saying me. David. So I never say, oh, Ghana, David.
Okay, now. All right, Mr. I know Whiskey. Ayo. Ayo.
Chebe, you said this now.
What are you doing?
What are you studying?
Ayo was quiet at that party. You understand?
I was just minding my business and drinking.
What are you studying in school? I'm studying Whiskey, though. So we said, well, now.